मनवीर कौर एंड शी वाज आवर स्टूडेंट ऑफ एरोस्पेस इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम सेकंड बैच एंड नाउ शी इज वर्किंग एज बिजनेस डेवलपर मैनेजर इन द एयर क्रू एविएशन प्राइवेट लिमिटेड एंड दिस कंपनी इज प्रोवाइडिंग सम ट्रेनिंग रिलेटेड टू पायलट ट्रेनिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट रिलेटेड ट्रेनिंग. ओके, सो शी विल गिव द डिटेल्स हाउ यू कैन चूज यूअर करियर इन द फ्यूचर आफ्टर द बीटेक एंड इन द बीटेक यू कैन हाउ कैन यू कैन यूज यूअर इंटर्नशिप्स एंड ट्रेनिंग्स. ओके, सो वी वेलकम मनवीर इन दिस लेक्चर.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay, so I'll now take up. So, good morning, everyone. I hope you all are safe and doing well. So, as sir have given my introduction, so I would like to add one thing. Like recently, on 1st July, I just got promoted to the director position. So now I am director of business development manage. So now I'm going to share my screen with you all. So, as Dr. Gurmeel Singh Malli has told you that we will going to have a closer look on how to become a pilot. So, let's get started with the today's presentation. And I want to mention something, like I don't want the session to be boring. So, if you come up with any of your doubts, so please let me know. So, I want the session to be really interactive. So before I start with the session, so can I have answers like, is there anyone out there who is willing to become a pilot, who dreams or aspire to be a pilot? Anyone?
Yes.
Anyone?
Yeah.
Okay,
Yes.
please tell me your name.
Akash Kumar.
All right, so is there anyone else? Okay, so now we'll start with our today's presentation, and I will be going to give you in-depth knowledge about how to become a pilot. So for starting, this is my business card. I am Director of Business Development with Air Aviator, which is the division of Air Cruise Aviation Private Limited. If you want to reach me, you can just have the screenshot of this card, and the mail ID is mentioned over here. So, to become a pilot, you could have two options. One is to be a commercial pilot, or another is to be an IAF with the fighter pilot for a particular air force of any country. So, first, I will be telling about to how to join in the Indian Air Force. So, there are basically four ways through which candidates can become Indian Air Force pilots. So, these can be National Defence Academy or Combined Defence Services, NCC entry, or Short Services Commission entry. So, NCC facilities we do have at campus, Chandigarh University. If you wish, you can enroll into NCC, give the exams, and you can have direct entry to the IAF. So, there are particularly courses that they are only the path to get into the IAF as flying officer. So while there are three ways which are considered to be permanent commission, the last one is a temporary one. So talking about the eligibility, that how to become an IAF, what is the eligibility? So to become an IAF pilot, the candidate should be an Indian pilot. It should have the Indian nationality only. So what are the educational qualifications required to become a pilot in Air Force? So the first comes here is the applicant must either be appearing or have 12th pass with physics or mathematics to appear in NDA exam. Or the second one is for CDSE or for NCC special entry, which I mentioned earlier. And the third comes is the AFCAT candidates. These should be like must be graduated, and engineering degree holders can also apply for the CDS exam. So you all must have heard the term AFCAT very often in your life. So AFCAT is the Air Force Defence Exam, which is conducted by the Indian Air Force like twice every year. So this is the one of the best option you can opt for for becoming IAF pilot. So talking about the age limit to become a pilot in Air Force, the first is the age limit should be between 16 to 19 years to appear for NCC. the exams, and the age limit should be 20 to 24 years to appear for CDSE, NCC, special entry, as well as the AFCET. So here comes the most interesting and interactive part of this presentation. So anybody out there would be like thinking about the salary packages, right? So the salary structure is really impressive if you join Indian Air Force. So here you can see the salary of flying officer or pilot is IAF is set as per the pay band. The pay band common is all to the branches, and you can see for the initial months you can get 15,000, 6,000 per month, and the grade pay will be 5,400 per month, including the military services that will be paying you 6,000 per month, and all the other allowances. So all of our, so the flying officer can have 66,110 rupees per month. So this is really very huge amount for any of the person getting just getting starting salary for the 66,000, right? Now that was all for the Indian Air Force pilot. Now we will be moving on to talk about the commercial pilot. So to become a commercial pilot, we should go with some initial steps, right? So the first is you need to check the eligibility as well as the requirements, because getting into any field, stepping in that, you need to know first if you are eligible for that and what are the requirements you need to have. Then second thing, which is the majorly and most demanded, is the, you have to get a second class medical certificate. Then third comes is you need to give first written exam, the theory exam, before starting your flying. So there are certain written exams which are conducted by the National Civil Authority of each country. Like for India, you must have heard about the DGCA. DGCA is the National Civil Authority, and FAA. Can you tell me FAA is of which country? Any answers? Is there anyone who knows what is FAA? Like no one in the batch. Guys, you are doing aerospace engineering. Please, you need to grab this knowledge. This is really required for you all.
I think it's US department.
Yes, yes. Can you please tell me your name?
Akash.
Great. So FAA is the National Civil Authority of United States of America. So if you get a certified pilot or CPL from the USA, then you are FAA pilot. So once you are done with the written exams, then your next step is that you will be going for the flying training. And then the last comes is that you have the check ride. So now we will talk in depth about the commercial pilot. So the first here comes is to become a pilot in any of the airlines, one must hold a CPL. So commercial pilot training is required for obtaining a CPL to fly commercial aircraft. So for obtaining a CPL, you should enroll yourself with any of the approved pilot training academies in India as well as in abroad. So you should be medically fit as per pilot standards and class 1 medicals for pilot, which I have mentioned earlier that you should be medical fit for the class 1 as well as for the class 2. So what is basically class 1 and 2? So these are basically categorized body health systems, which are categorized into two parts. Then next comes is you have to gain 200 hours of flying, which is required for your license. Then there are the written exams which is conducted by the DGCA. So can I have the full form of DGCA? Is there anyone who knows the full form of DGCA? Any answers? If you don't know, please let me know. That is really okay. Like you are just beginners and you are learning and I am here to teach you only. If there is no answer, okay. Can anybody tell me?
Directorate General of Civil Aviation.
Yes, correct. So DGCA is the National Authority of India, and you should be know about this term DGCA. So for the CPL, DGCA conducts written exams once in a 3 months, and you should clear. So what are these basic exams are for? So you could be having five different topics. One is aviation meteorology, air regulations, air navigation, technical general, and technical specific. So to become a pilot, there could be two methods to get your training, right? So the first is you can get into any conventional program, or second is to get to, you can get admission in cadet pilot program. So first we'll have a closer look on the conventional program. So to get into the conventional program, you need to first clear your DGC exams, the written exams which I just shown you in the previous slide. And then you need to apply for your computer number and you need to get your CPL. CPL is commercial pilot license, of course. And then you need to do the type rating and you have to apply for the job and then you are really good to fly. Here I have put a list of some of the best flying clubs of India. So I have listed in the 8 numbers. So the first one is Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Udan Academy. Second is a Nifty of
India. Finished.
Pardon? Am I audible please, to everyone?
Please, other students, please yes. Keep on mute mode.
All right.
Yes. But if, right.
Ash, if you have any question, you can raise your hand, okay?
Sir, the screen is stuck.
Okay, screen is stuck.
Can you tell me which slide can you see?
Manvi, shift your screen.
How to become a pilot. First right. Slide.
Only fastest slide is visible.
Okay, just give me a minute. There could be some technical issue with my laptop.
Click on second slide. Yes. Now it is changed.
All right. So, can you see the new slide? List of some flying clubs in India?
Yes.
All right. Okay, thank you. Okay, so I was talking about the best flying clubs in India. So, here I have listed it. So, first one is Indira Gandhi Rashtriya Udan Academy, which is in UP. And the second one comes is the Oxford Gwalior, which is in Madhya Pradesh. Then third comes is Times Aviation Academy, Sagar, Madhya Pradesh. So first thing I would like to tell you is that all these academies or the flying clubs which I have listed here, these academies provide Indian DGCA license only. So if you are willing to get DGCA, you can enroll into any of these academies. So you will be having your theory as well as flying exams only in India and you will be getting DGCA license. But if you wish to have license of another country like FAA or CEA, like you want to have a pilot license of Canada, New Zealand, America, Australia, so you can opt for the flying in another countries as well. So I'll come to that later. So for this, if you wish to have a DGCA license, you should need to enroll in any of the flying clubs in India and you need to do your flying hours in India only. So that was the conventional program. Now I'll be talking about the cadet pilot program. So cadet pilot program is basically, if you want to have a CPL, you can directly enroll into any of the airline which is offering such CPL courses. So in India, here we have three major license, the three major airlines who are providing you the CPL program. So the first one is Indigo Airlines, SpiceJet Airlines, and AirAsia Airlines. You can enroll into any of your three favorite airline and get your CPL. So what is the eligibility to get as a commercial pilot?
Manvi, so change the slide and if you have changed.
So can you tell me which slide I
list of some flying clubs. Okay, manually you have to shift that slide. Yes. Okay, now it is okay.
So can you see the eligibility slide?
Yes.
Okay, so the first comes here is you must be Indian citizen. And the second is about your age. You should be between the age of 18 to 30 years. Then third point comes here is you should have minimum 60% in your 10th plus in your 12th as in physics and maths. And you must be fluent in English language, of course, because you need to fly with the international level as well. Then you must be holding a valid Indian passport. So can you all see the next slide here, which I have put it, the DGCA commercial pilot license. This is a sample picture. Can you all see this? The next slide, which I have shown. So I'll just, like, it isn't working on the full screen mode, so I'll just work it like this only. So can you see a sample picture of a DGCA commercial pilot license? Can anybody confirm me?
Yes.
All right. So this is how DGCA CPL looks like. So it consists of mainly a photograph, your license number, your name, date of birth, nationality, validity, everything, and the seal of DGCA, right?
Government is not required.
So far I have told you each and everything about eligibility, requirement, and criteria to get in as a CPL. So now I will be moving forward with the most awaited and most common query of any person, like how to get scholarship into CPL. Because all of us knows that to get any CPL license, you need to spend around 30 to 40 lakhs. And this is really a huge amount for a common man to pay, right? So there are various scholarships available for pilots. So first scholarship I want to mention is here, that Saraswati Aviation Academy. So scholarship by Saraswati Aviation Academy. So these are the candidates whose whole income is less than 1 lakh. So they are eligible to fill this form by the online mode. And more than this, candidate needs to submit the following documents along with the application on the mail ID. And here you can see the certificate which they ask usually. That is your income certificate, your domicile certificate, caste certificate, and two passport size color photographs. So another comes is the scholarship by Air India. So two scholarship each of amount 4 lakhs are given to the deserving candidates on the basis of the merit in every batch. And the next scholarship here comes by the Indian Airlines. So two scholarship each of 4 lakhs are given to the deserving candidates in every aviation batch. So eligibility to take admission is based on your 12th marks, which is based in like maths as well as in physics subject. So the fourth scholarship comes here is scholarship by Government Aviation Training Institute. So GATI is known as Government Aviation Training Institute, which is known to offer flying and pilot training program in India for students. The institute often fellowship ground in meritorious students of SC and ST students, and candidates will be selected on the basis of 12th marks in the board. And the next scholarship here is by the JRD Tata Memorial. So every year the board of director of JRD Tata Memorial give 10 lakhs in the scholarship to the pilot training. So the four students are given scholarship of rupees 1 lakh each for the pilot training. And here we have one special like reserved category for the SC and ST. So a reserve category candidate belonging to the SC or ST is given rupees 2 lakh as scholarship for the training pilot. So one thing that I would like to mention over here is that, as we already know, that getting into CPL is equal to spending more of your money. And so far we have seen that you are getting nothing but no more than 4 lakh as a scholarship. So it is all up to you that if you want to go.
Are these options after their graduation?
Yes, sir, there are options after the graduation, like which I have told. People can enroll for, like, if they are done with the higher study, higher education, they can directly enroll. Or if they have done graduation, that is well enough. So if you want to get into CPL, you can enter up to the age of the 30 years. So then no matters if you have done graduation or your post-graduation. Well, it no matters in the AFCAT entry, in the Air Force entry, because they have a little less age limit. So you need to get very early, at your early age, into IAF. Because okay. Soon you
is
get...
Is there to, any test for this scholarship?
No, this is scholarship is based on upon your first. Some of them are based upon the performance while you are studying in particular institute, are some of the scholarship are there who is offering the special like I can see for this SC and SC students. So people can directly who are having like income less than 1 lakh per annum, they can directly enroll into such scholarship programs.
Okay.
Yes. So is there any other doubt which I can clear? All right. So now moving on, I was talking about like spending into CPL is really more, right? So you need to like have a correct decision. Like if you are financially free and you can like pay a huge amount, so only you should go for the scholarship only. So here another important question comes is that how to finance your career in commercial pilot. Because spending 40 lakhs within the time span of 18 months is really like for our parents, actually this is too much, right? Because they have already spent a lot on our studies, and further we are asking to give us 30 to 40 lakhs for our CPF. So how to finance your career in commercial pilot? So that you can have education loan for the commercial pilot training. So nowadays there are many private as well as public sector banks which are ready to lend an education loan to students for commercial pilot course. So many private flying aviation academy providing commercial pilot courses have made collaboration banks to help the students to get bank loan easily with the study. So a student is advised to consult the financial officer of the academy to receive educational loans or other financial aid offered by the academy. So here you can see a list of few banks which offer you CPL education loan. So for to check if you are eligible or not, a student must check his or eligibility for education loan from a nationalized bank. So the first step what banks do is that they verify college in which candidate is going to enroll himself for the course. The college should be approved by DGCA. A candidate should be citizen of India and preferably should be within the age of 16 to 35 years. So a bank usually grants 15 lakh education loan to the candidates for pursuing his or her course in India and 20 lakhs education loan to students who want to pursue their course outside the India. So here you can, this is how you can expense your loan. You can expense your loan on the fees of course, and then the hostel fees, examination fees, refundable deposits, expenses of books, instruments, expenses on like some which is required by the college, expenses of traveling abroad and many other. So here I have listed some of the documents which you will require while applying for an education loan. First of all is admission letter from the college, like completely filled admission form of the candidate, program or tuition fee which is charged by the college per semester or per year, complete academy record of candidate, mark sheet and certificates of class 10th and other qualification examination. So an affidavit that should be submitted by the candidate stating that he or she is not taken any loan from any another bank. Address proof, of course, and the ID proof should be submitted. PAN card, voter card, Aadhaar card, driving license will be considered as the ID proof. So bank will also submit post loan document, that is post due security check loans or agreement paper, and that is mandate applicable. So here I have put one disclaimer for you all. Well, I have told you about scholarship as well as the loan procedures you can have. But one thing which I want to mention is usually what we think is once we are done with our course, we will immediately get a job, right? So it is not true actually in your real life, because I don't want to misguide you all. So once you are done with your CPL, you are done with your like course, 18 months or whatever you have opted for the CPL, you will take, it will usually take 2 to 3 years to get into any particular airlines. So the reason being that in your 18 months course, you will be only able to have only 200 of flying hours. And to get into the any particular airline, they usually demand the flying hours as in 1500. So you can guess the difference between 1500 and 200 flying hours, right? So to complete that difference, you need to work as an instructor initially. You can become an instructor and teach other people flying. So that is how you can do your job as well as you can complete your flying hours. And even like if you have taken the loan from the bank, so it will definitely going to take 2 to 3 years, because being an instructor is, you would be having a little less salary as compared to any airline pilot, right? So this is what I want to make you all clear initially, that it will take 2 to 5 years to get as a airline pilot, and the same years to repay the amount of your loan. Although a commercial pilot enjoys a respectable career and status in the society. Okay, so now here I am going to tell you a little brief about the company in which I am working right now. So this company, Aircruz Aviation Private Limited, is an aviation startup which got up in 2018, and it is well traveled by the pilot. So it is a well recognized by the government of India, and this company provides various services. So services they provide are aviation BPM, air charters, pilot training, aviation HR services, air charters. They provide aviation related books, apps, lead generation, link, and many, many more. So here, as I have mentioned earlier, that I am into the company who provides international airline pilot training. So here I have put a one poster. So soon our company is going to start with the batch, which is going to commence on the 15th August. So in our company, Captain Pratna Khandelwal, she is the chief ground instructor. If you have any inquiry regarding you need to have more counseling, you can contact us. So we provide online flying classes in other countries as well, like in Australia, Canada, New Zealand, Philippines, and USA. These are the major countries in which we are sending students for their flying training. We conduct online course for the ground batches, and then we send candidates to their favorite countries.
Okay.
So here is the complete details. So if you wish, you want to have any career counseling, you can have screenshot of this slide. So Captain Shekhar Gupta, he is the author and the pilot. So he is there to guide you for your career as in pilot. Then here is me. So I provide online career counseling for aerospace engineering as well as for the aircraft maintenance engineering. If you are seeking any of the career guidance, you can have screenshot and you can reach us anytime. So apart from that, our companies also conduct international aviation management internships. And other than aviation, we do have many other options like finance, marketing, blogging, YouTube, blogger and all. So you can reach us for more inquiries. So here is, here in this poster, you can see a resume term written here. So this is one thing which I really want to tell you all about is, like, so far we are familiar with the resume, right? The old traditional way to write up all of your bio into a document and send to the HRs. So nowadays we already know that people due to the pandemic are not having jobs, and HR are receiving more number of resumes, and they somehow felt it little hectic to read 2 to 3 pages for a particular person. So our company has come up with an innovative way, that is resume, your video resume. So what we do is we provide expert advice for your resume. We try to build your video resume, and we can connect you with the aviation HRs. So we provide you the airline ready resume, and this is applicable for the pilots, cabin crews, AMEs, and for the ground staffs. And other than that, if you are into any other of the profession, you can opt for this option. So here I have mentioned about the online certificate program, which is upcoming program that is conducted by our company. So this program will familiar about you the airport management as well as the customer services. So if you join this program, the fees is really less. This is 1 week program, and this is for 1,000 rupees only. And you will be getting certificate of participation and complimentary resume, which I mentioned. This is free for all who are attending this program. You can have free recording seminars, and you can use it for your later use. And if you get enrolled into such particular program, you will be having a wide idea and you can discover about your career choice in the future. So here's another certificate online course which is ongoing right now with the company, the former international cabin crew Richa Maheshwari. I hope some of you or all of you might know her, like she is really famous and famous spokesperson. So right now we are conducting one aviation soft skill and personality development program with her, and we are having another program with her that is cabin crew and air hostess online training. Apart from that, this is a picture of Captain Urmila Ravi Shankar. So she is FAA certified pilot. There is the team of the captain, as you can see. So other than that, we have international collaboration with the US company that is Simply Cloud, and we are going to have another online training. And if any of in the audience is like want to have a career as a coach or as a motivational speaker, so we do provide at the best international education, and we will provide you a chance to be an online international career coach or to become a motivational speaker. And this is how you can earn up to 50,000 or more per month. So here is the contact information of our company. If any of you has found anything interesting and you want to reach us for the trainings, internships, anything, so you can call or mail us. We do provide internships and trainings for the various
types. Let me show the contact slide.
Alright. I'll just put it in full screen mode. Is this like visible to everyone?
Yes.
Okay, so you can just have screenshot of the slide, and if you wish to have any of your career guidance, you want to have any of the trainings, you can feel free to reach at this number. So in the next slide, I have put my visiting card, my business card. You can if you wish to reach me, you can just like have a screenshot of this slide too, where you can have my contact number. This is my WhatsApp contact as well, and my email ID is also mentioned. So this is a brief bio of me. You can connect with me on LinkedIn as well. You can see this picture as same profile picture over there. So here I have mentioned my V card as well as my email information. So I hope you would have found this session really interactive and informative. If you have any inquiry regarding getting any of your internships or trainings, you can feel free to contact me. I would be happy to help you all. So can I have a little feedback from the audience, like how do you found the session, like was it interactive for you all?
Students, please give you a feedback. Revant. Gagan, Revant, Gaurav.
All right, that is really okay. So I hope
we will give feedback in the last.
Sure.
Okay. So here we have to, I think, Manveer, we have to conclude.
Yes. So, okay. So for the today's session, we have had a really depth knowledge about how to become a pilot. So in India, we can have the option to join Indian Air Force, or you can opt for the commercial pilot. And I have told about the requirement, the eligibility, and all the written exams which are really required. Also have told about the scholarship as well as the educational finance things which you can opt for your career. And then I gave a few briefing about my company and a few briefing about the various trainings and the courses which we provide to the people. So this is all about my today's session. Thank you all for listening to me. I hope I'll have another session with you all if you found this really informative. Thank you all for having me.
Okay, Manveer, thanks a lot for sparing your valuable time for us.
Thank you, ma'am.
So it is very useful session for us. and the students as well. And I hope they will get the knowledge and about the how you they can pursue a pilot training program. And the part of your lecture that is about the scholarship, that was very impressive, because this training is very costly. If somebody like somebody will not each and everybody will not spend 30 lakh or 40 lakhs, okay? So some students probably get motivated to get these scholarships. And moreover, your training program, I'm really impressed by your training programs that that will be useful at lowest cost, useful for the students. Like they can opt like 1 week program online at this stage also. In the future, I hope our students will get engaged with your organization in the training and internship program. So thanks, Manveer, from our class. And there is one, Manveer, there is one more class. One more section is there.
All right. Okay.
More section is there, and you can, I will.